Hi everyone, my name is Michelle Crusoe. Welcome to my channel where you learn how to get hired and thrive in the film industry. If you're new here, please be sure to subscribe. Today I'll be covering how to do a digital purchase order using DPO. Now this may vary from show to show, studio to studio. Productions are starting to pick back up post-COVID, and this is one of the platforms that my show is using to make purchase orders digital. Now I'll just be showing how to use the actual software platform for specifics on how to fill out a purchase order or PO, or even what that is. Check out my ebook. I'll leave a link below. All right, let's dive in. All right, here is an example of what the digitalpurchaseorder.com website looks like. Be sure to save whatever link accounting gives you in your bookmark so you can easily find it again. So just click on your production, and then to create a new PO, go to create new PO. And on this show, I'm working in construction. Type in the supplier. With POs, you'll have an account per vendor, so it should automatically populate. If it's the first time you're putting in that vendor, you may have to put in all that information. Now, here's where it gets interesting. You have to have a quote before you can get a PO number. So they already gave me the quote. I'll have it in another window here. And this is different from the way hard copy POs were. You didn't have this item and then description. So for the item, I kind of just keep it a general description. And then within the description, that's where I get more detailed. And be sure to be as detailed as possible. You know, for construction, it's a little more everything's wood. But in set deck, you know, you may have to look up, where do we get this specific couch, and what does the couch look like? What is it made out of? How big is it? So I try to be as descriptive as possible. All right, so we got our description in. Is it purchase or rental? In this case, it's a purchase. And I'm putting quantity as one. Now you, some accounting departments may want you to see how I have in my description is 25 of this knotty pine and 25 of this spruce. They may want you to divide those out, but then I have to, you know, put the tax in and if there's any shipping. But for my accounting department in this studio, they seem to be fine with the way I'm doing it. Because too, it can get tricky with rentals. You know, sometimes you may get a discount on the third or fourth week. So mathematically, it's not going to work out if you can only use one unit. So this is my workaround that fortunately works for my accounting department, but you know, when in doubt, ask questions. Every accountant in every accounting department is going to be different. All right, so I put in quantity one, the net price, I just put the whole total of the quote down there. Now accounting codes, again, I go over this more in my ebook. But for this one, I'm going to go ahead and put in the proper accounting code. And you get these codes from accounting. Hit add. Okay, so that created your PO. And this is, you know, you go to notes. I didn't see a place to put what set it was for. So I put it in my notes area. And again, I checked with accounting, you know, hey, I didn't see a column for set. Where should I put that? Attachments. This is where you can attach your quote. Go ahead and drop it in. Turn screen, hit close, and then you can see there's an attachment one, new PO. And then voila, got my PO number. And either hit continue or new PO, depending on what your next course of action is. And be sure to pass on the PO number to your vendor. Okay, now hit this button to get the PDF of your PO. Hit download. There it is. And go ahead and file it away in the specific area you'd like to put it. As you can see me clicking through, I have what department it's going through, scans, my POs, and then I'd like to rename it like this, PO number underscore the vendor. say something changed and you had to get an updated quote, you'll need to amend the PO. So click on the PO that you need to amend and then hit this plus sign. Now for this one, I don't have any reason to revise it, but sometimes, you know, you'll get a quote and it doesn't include tax, or you need to add something to that quote later on, in which case you'd attach the new quotes. So you'd hit attach and then put in whatever changes you need to. And then there'll be a spot to put your amend comment so they can see why it was amended. You can say plus tax or updated quote, what have you. And then I think you hit save or approve, and then it'll amend the PO from there. Now here's what the PDF looks like when you have an exported PO from the DPO system. Here's where your vendor is listed. Your PO number will be listed in the upper right-hand corner. And what's in bold within the description is your item, and then underneath it is your description. And this is where, you know, it gets a little bit different from the hard copy POs where it says ACC number. That used to say ACCT. And I feel like they should have both the coding number as well as the description. Being in this case, this description is set construction materials. So that's something, you know, that I suggested to whoever made this DPO website. You know, it doesn't quite make sense as I'm entering it into my budget because I use the number, not the description. And then same with, you know, notes. There used to be a column that said set, and now we have it in notes. And I always like to put the set number and what the set name is, because as it's going around for approvals, not everyone may have their set list handy. And the set list is generated by the art department. And also, your department may or may not need to code items to set. So if this is new for you, you know, check with your boss. And this is where it gets a little odd. So the date on the DPOs are actually at the very bottom. So the date of a PO is when the PO itself was generated. And then there's our quote that we attach. So it's kind of nice. It's all in one spot versus the way I used to do it is I would still do this, you know, hard copy wise, but this, it would be a scan. So here's an example where I did an amended PO. As you can see, it says revision 1, but you know, it kept my same PO, which is really nice. That's what I originally put in. Here we go, amended, and then, oh, hey, look, someone approved already. So with the amended ones, I kind of wish, and there may be a way to do this, that it would get rid of the original, and you can always do it just on your back end, but within the system, it looks like it keeps everything, which is, you know, fine, but can be a little confusing. So hopefully whoever's going around to approve this will see, oh, there's an amended portion, I need to keep scrolling. And for my files, personally, I think I'll just keep the amended portion because that's what is gonna go in, that's what got spent at the end of the day. Thank you so much for watching. Please comment below with any questions or comments or suggestions. And let me know what other technology your show may be using.